Christmas. This memo of the mouse will be in the gift bag. It's free. Please read it. It's not just an autobiography, but it has some solid nuggets that will guide everyone. Because the best way forward is by looking at the history of a successful man. In this book, we have the story of my dad, Mark Omar, Eyoyibo. The title is very, very related. It's called The Memo of a Mouse. See, one question that I asked him was, why did we use this title? And he had a whole lot to tell me. And what I concluded from it is that the mouse is a very peculiar personality. It is subtle, but I dare say inherent. The aura of the mouse fills the room with an recognizable presence. The mouse breathes, eats, and talks through its life incognito. It is very remarkable, the mouse. It's against this backdrop that my daddy Bonnie takes on the metaphorical title of the mouse. When you go through this book, it tells you the vicissitudes of life that he has to go through. From his birth, and where he was laid, how he caught on fire. Just to read a couple of things from the book. It starts off by saying that nature attains perfection. By the way, this is a quote by Eric Hoffer. It says, quote, nature attains perfection, but man never does. There's a perfect ant, a perfect bee, but man is perpetually unfinished. He's both an unfinished animal and an unfinished man. It is this incurable unfinishedness which sets man apart from other living things. And then it goes on to talk about what the basis for him writing this book is. And it says that these reflections have been written as a challenge to you, the reader. It is meant for his amusement and to attest to his passion for writing. It is his desire also that it be of interest to us as children, that he calls us his brothers and sisters now. He says that the book is curious because the author is not a peculiar creature, just like a mouse. A mouse can be in a house and we don't know, but we see the evidence of the mouse, the trappings and what have you. And he talks about love, how he met my mom, the late Eyoyibo, the legend, one that told and gave her life for so many. He talks about his early life as a child growing up. He talks about his education and his career as well. The different jobs that he had. He talks about envy, what is shunning him and giving the promotion to someone else. And the book is so profound. I encourage you all to read this book. Believe me, the nuggets you get here will transform your life right now. Saves you the toil of experiments. Only a book saves you the challenges of going through life by yourself. You can learn from the experiences of someone that has been there before. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you The Memoirs of a Man.
So please, we call Engineer Lawrence Achuya to unveil the first book review. Engineer, sir, the robot.
Our chief celebrant and the wife, distinguished guests here present, you're welcome. You have just been given a preview sun has taken you through. I was here, want to launch it or unveil it so that people can launch, pay for it, and share it in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you very much, engineer. This one is free. The first book is free. The Memoir of a Mouse, that is a celebrant's autobiography. The celebrant and octogenarian. Be funny.
And I wonder what those are about.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, quickly, before the Oboko comes to perform courtesy, Ubadi Shakiri, United Kingdom, permit me to call on Mrs. Wes Aleno to come and review the next book, The Vanity of Human Life, The Nigerian Perspective. This one must be launched. Shakiri, again.
The chairman, Chiefs, members of the Rectable, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please permit me to start this one. Like you said, my name is Mrs. Eyewuwai, BSc, MSc, PGD, MNIM, member of Nigerian School of Management, Charter. I'm a senior assistant registrar of the College of Education of Nigeria. The book I'm about to review is titled The Vanity of Human Life. You're going to have a chance to start with the past.